Take a look around. This is our church. This is church. And with everything we have tonight, with all that goes on in this place, our desire is that our hearts would truly connect with our Creator. That as we come together and as we sing with one voice, we join our hearts and we sing these songs, we declare the glory of our God. That God would be allowed to be God in this place, that God would be God in our hearts. So we're going to sing and we're going to dance and we're going to praise God with everything. From the outset, let your hearts not be prepared for an album recording or for lights and music or anything like that, but prepare your hearts to encounter the living God, because that's what's going to happen in this place. And we can put all the expectations on that we like. But I don't know what will happen if we allow God to truly invade our lives, invade our hearts, invade this place the way I really know that He wants to. So we're going to stand and we're going to pray. Isaiah 42 says, I am the Lord, that is my name. I will not give my glory to another or my praise to idols. See, the former things have taken place, and new things I declare. Before they spring into being, I announce them to you. So sing to the Lord a new song, His praise from the ends of the earth. You who go down to the sea and all that is in it, you islands and all who live in them. Let the desert and its towns raise their voices. Let the settlements where Kedar lives rejoice. Let the people of Selah sing for joy. Let them shout from the mountaintops. Let them give glory to the Lord and proclaim His praise in the islands. The Lord will march out like a mighty man, like a warrior. He will stir up His zeal. With a shout, He will raise the battle cry and will triumph over His enemies. Lift up a shout of praise to God in this place.
Yeah.
come together. I want one desire to praise you and lift you up. And I surrender with eyes on high. We praise you with one voice. We come together. I want one desire to praise you and lift you up. Cause we are living in faith.
In my
Jesus. Say what they want.
He had equal status with God, but didn't think so much of himself that he had to cling to the advantages of that status no matter what. Not at all. When the time came, he set aside the privileges of deity and took on the status of a slave, became human. Having become human, he stayed human. It was an incredibly humbling process. He didn't claim special privileges. Instead, he lived a selfless, obedient life and then died a selfless, obedient death. And the worst kind of death at that. a crucifixion. Because of that obedience, God lifted him high and honored him far above anyone or anything ever, so that all created beings in heaven and on earth, even those long ago dead and buried, will bow in worship before this Jesus Christ and call out in praise that he is the master of all, to the glorious honor of God the Father.
Thank you. His love that came for us, humbled to the sinner's cross. He broke my shame and sinfulness, and rose again victorious. Sets me free, Jesus Christ, who lives in me. When you say, you are stronger, you are stronger, sin is broken, you have saved me. It is written, Christ is risen, Jesus, you are Lord.
What we have heard and we have seen. Who would have thought that God's saving power would look like this? The servant grew up before God, a scrawny seedling, a scrubby plant in a parched field. There was nothing attractive about him, nothing to cause us to take a second look. He was looked down on and passed over. A man who suffered, who knew pain firsthand. One look at him and people turned away. We looked down on him. We thought he was scum. But the fact is, it was our pains that he carried. Our disfigurements. All the things wrong with us. We thought that he bore it on himself, that God was punishing him for his own failures, but it was our sins that did that to him, that ripped and tore and crushed him. Our sins. He took the punishment, and that made us whole. And by his stripes, we are healed.
You are born.
you say?
Say power.
Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick darkness is over the peoples, but the Lord rises upon you, and his glory appears over you. Nations will come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your eyes and look about you. All assemble and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters are carried on the arm. Then you will look and be radiant. Your heart will throb and swell with joy. The wealth on the seas will be brought to you. To you, the riches of the nations will come. No longer will violence be heard in your land, nor ruin or destruction within your borders. But you will call your walls salvation, and your gates praise. The sun will no more be your light by day, nor will the brightness of the moon shine on you. For the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory. Your sun will never set again, and your moon will wane no more. The Lord will be your everlasting light, and your days of sorrow will end. Then will all your people be righteous, and they will possess the land forever. They are the shoot I have planted, the work of my hands for the display of my splendor. The least of you will become a thousand, the smallest a mighty nation. I am the Lord. In its time, I will do this swiftly. Come on, are you ready to keep praising God? Come on, let's go.
Your power, that your enemies cringe before you. All the earth bows down to you. They sing praise to you. They sing praise to your name, God. Come and see what the Lord has done, how awesome his works in man's behalf. He turned the sea into dry land. They passed through the waters on foot. come, let us rejoice in him. He rules forever by his power. His eyes watch the nations. Let not the rebellious rise up against him. Praise our God, O peoples. Let the sound of his praise be heard. He has preserved our lives and kept our feet from slipping. For you, O God, tested us. You refined us like silver. You brought us into prison and laid burdens on our backs. You let men ride over our heads when we went through fire and water, but you brought us to a place of abundance. Come and listen, all you who fear God. Let me tell you what he has done for me. For I cried out to him with my mouth, and his praise was on my tongue. If I had cherished sin in my heart, the Lord would not have listened. But God has surely listened and heard my voice in prayer. Praise be to God, who has not rejected my prayer or withheld his love from me.
Yeah.
There's nothing on earth in this life that could ever separate us, Lord. Your love is never ending. To your hands we surrender. Where all our sins are washed away. Your grace be unwritten as paid for our freedom. We're made alive in you. We run to your throne where we belong. Every heart will sing that Jesus is Lord. Casting all else aside for the joy of our Christ. Let your glory unfold.
Isaiah 6 says, come, let us return to the Lord.
He has torn us to pieces, but he will heal us. He has injured us, but he will bind up our wounds. After 2 days, he will revive us. On the third day, he will restore us, that we may live in his presence. Let us acknowledge the Lord, and let us press on to acknowledge him. As surely as the sun rises, he will appear. He will come to us like the winter rains, like the spring rains that water the earth.
Raise your hands to heaven. Express your thanksgiving to God. Right around this auditorium. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. You are worthy, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honor and power. For you created all things, and by your will they were created and have their being. You are worthy because you were slain, and with your blood you purchased men for God from every tribe and language and people and nation.
You have made them to be a kingdom and priests to serve our God, and they will reign on the earth. Worthy is the Lamb who is slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and praise. To him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be praise and honor and glory and power forever and ever and ever.
Now keep your hands toward heaven and open them high to receive heaven's blessing, to fulfill this task, this divine mandate on earth, to bring justice where there is injustice, and hope where there is hopelessness, peace where there is anxiety, love where there is fear, salvation where there is brokenness. And now may this God, our God, the God of peace, who through the blood of the eternal covenant brought back from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, that great shepherd of the sheep, equip you with everything good for doing his will. And may he work in us what is pleasing to him through Jesus Christ. To him be glory forever and ever. And may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Come on, one last praise to God. Lift up your voice. Go and change the world. God bless you. Good night. Thank you.